Welcome back to Magic Tarot Cards. It's Jasmine. I have a 7-card spread here for you. This is for all zodiac signs. This is from February 15th through February 21st, your weekly energy for next week. Mercury retrograde is going to go direct on February 21st. So we will be out of that phase. So you still have this week for things to happen. So I'm going to give you these energies. And we will go from here. This is for all zodiac signs. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, y'all. Hit that notification bell. If you want to be notified of another video that I upload, give me a big thumbs up, y'all. And don't forget that this video is not for kids. If you're under the age of 18, please click off now. Also, this channel is my brand. Do not attempt to copy my work for any reason. All right. Here I am drinking coffee. This morning, it is very, very cold here in Texas. It's snowing in Dallas, Texas. And, yeah, I got my coffee here. I get these little cups at Walmart for $1. These are the cutest cups. I just love them. I have all colors. Excuse me. Let's get started with the reading. This weather has my throat acting funny. And I have the sniffles. Prince, no. My daughter's dog is here. I'm babysitting him because she went off with her boyfriend, you know, to celebrate Valentine's Day. So I have Prince. Come here, Prince. I don't know. I'm going to pick up the camera, y'all, and show you Prince. That's Prince. Sorry about the stuff in the background. I have some boxes and laundry sitting in that corner. I have a box there with a frame, and then I have a picture frame here I'm working on. So I got stuff that I am working on, so forgive the mess, but that is Prince. Prince, look up here. There you go. That's my daughter's dog, okay? So anyway, let's get started with the reading. For the first one, I am seeing Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius. This is a person that's very sneaky from your past. I see he came in, he or she, could be man or woman, came in. In the past, they were sneaky. They came to you saying they love you, wanted to be with you, promised you the moon, the stars, and everything in between, and then they cheated. Okay, so this is the Seven of Swords. You see how he is sneaking off, looking over his shoulder, making sure nobody saw him steal the swords. Very sneaky, tiptoeing. Okay, I hear you, Prince. I hear you. He wants food. And, yeah, so this could have been you in the past finding out about this person. It's a Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius, or you could be a Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius, but this has Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius energy. Also, this person was talking to multiple people. That's what these swords represent, multiple people. These tents in the background represent sexual activity. This person could have been having sex with all these multiple people or online, calling the 1-800 numbers, chat lines, prostitution, and it involves anything that has to do with sex other than with you. Okay, but this person left evidence behind. That's what these two swords represent, and you found out. Okay, so that's why it fell in the reverse. In the reverse, this represents the ex coming back. There is the ex coming back here. This is the player. Okay, coming back in. Mercury retrograde brings in exes because they get nostalgic during this phase. We've had Mercury retrograde from, January 17th through February 21st. Or no, it wasn't 17th. It was the 31st through February 21st. Sorry. We've been in Mercury retrograde. It does cause breakups, relationship problems, truths coming out. So this is truths coming out. You found out about this ex, what he was up to, what he or she were doing. But he's coming back. He or she are coming back, if they haven't already, with an apology. Okay, and they're going to be saying, I'm sorry for causing so much trouble. Oops, I didn't mean to do it. Honest, I didn't. But this is fake. It's not real. Do not believe it, because they will be gone with the wind on February 21st as soon as Mercury goes direct. They do not stay. They only come in to cause more trouble or to see what else they can get out of you. So do not trust this ex coming back. They're very deceptive person. They keep secrets, but the secret will be revealed. They might tell you themselves what really happened, or you found out through these swords that were back here that was evidence, maybe a text message, an email, a phone call, or something. That's how you found out, a post on, you know, social media. Okay. I'm seeing a thief returning something that they stole. You could have been at your desk a couple of weeks ago or last month. Someone stole something off your desk, and then they all of a sudden it returns. You see, find it back at your desk, and you're like, oh my God, where did this come from? Because the thief decided to get honest and put it back on your desk. Anything like that is possible. Mercury retrograde brings massive car accidents, and we had one here in Texas on Thursday. It was a massive 100-car pile up. And yes, the roads were icy, but this does happen during Mercury retrograde. The reason it was massive is because Venus is traveling with Mercury. Venus enhances everything it touches. So with Mercury, it enhanced this car accident that brought it to a 100-car pileup. It was tragic. If you haven't seen it already, y'all, go watch the videos. Car crash in Fort Worth, Texas. It was horrible. All right. Let's go to the next card. Sorry, y'all, my camera's moving. Now we have the Knight of Wands. This is the X. Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius, or Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius. It could be any sign coming back. Again, they could be coming back this week or already have come back, telling you they want another chance. They're coming in quick. You see how the horse is flying through the air? He's very, very intent. Look at his face. Very intent on coming back. Wants to start something again. Maybe wants your money, your car, or just to see what you're up to. Again, do not trust this person. He has three people attached to him. There's one, two, three in the back. There's three people that are attached to him that he's talking to. You're not the only one, okay? So be careful. This is also, card can represent quick travel. You see how the salamanders are on the robe here? That represents protection as you travel. So if you are going on a quick trip, be careful, beware. You're gonna need protection because, again, we are in Mercury retrograde. You have a greater chance of crashing during this phase. If I was you, just stay your butt at home, okay? All right, so let's move on to the next one. Here we have the Hierophant. This card represents the lure of confirmation, okay? The judge is sitting high up in his chair. He's holding both hands up, representing his power. Hold on. No more, Prince. That's enough. You've had enough to eat. Go on over there. That little doggy, all he wants to do is eat. Okay, so I gave him some of my turkey sticks. This is what I was snacking on, these turkey sticks. So I gave him a few. He really likes them. Anyway, he Hierophant is a judge. Could be a lawyer, a teacher, a doctor, your boss, someone that's higher up, that sits higher up. See how he's sitting higher up than the people here? These people here are waiting on a decision. The Hierophant is here to confirm. This is the lure of confirmation. He's confirming something that you've been waiting on. Some of you are waiting on court cases, money, a decision. The decision would be yes. The answer would be yes. No, Prince, no more. No more. Can y'all hear him crying? He's right here next to me crying. This also can confirm the information that came right before it, which is, because it fell right next to these cards, which is the X coming back. It's also confirming that. So if you're waiting on to hear from something or someone or a court case or something like that, you're going to get the answer. It's going to be confirmation. And I believe the answer is yes. Whatever it is that you're waiting on, the answer is yes. This card does represent Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. So if you're one of those signs, you could be waiting on, an answer for something. I am seeing that some people are trying to be more popular on social media. Be careful what you put out there, okay? Because not everybody is your friend on social media. Some people are only befriending you because they want to destroy your life. So be careful with that. I am seeing that as well, all right? Prince, I can hear you. I hear you. I'm busy. I will hold you in a minute, okay? Little dog whining. So here we have next the Two of Pentacles. This is when you have, and the upright represents balancing a mist of problems. So if you have had money problems, because these are the Pentacles, if you've had money problems in the past, you were trying as hard as you can. Everyone has, actually, during this terrible event we've been having with the virus and stuff. Everyone has had money problems. You see the water in the back? It's wavy. It's going all up and down. The ships aren't balanced. Amidst the problems, you've been able to balance. You see how the man is standing on one foot? He's balancing. Very passionate. Red represents passion. Very passionate about balancing his problems. And then there's the infinity sign. So whatever decision you make during this phase is going to last for a while. So make sure you make the right decision. But it fell in the reverse. So in the reverse, it means something totally opposite. In the upright, it means small profit also as well coming in. But in the reverse, it means you have too many problems. You're not able to balance things out. So I see that for a lot of people, not being able to balance things out, their money. I'm seeing disorganization between couples. I'm seeing disorganization at a workplace or something like that. Too much to handle. So think about what it is you need to do, what you need to let go so you can move forward from there. Make future plans. I'm seeing someone that needs to think ahead. You need to think ahead before you make future plans so your plans won't fail. Okay? Yeah. You might have to let some of these pentacles go. Maybe you got too many projects going where you can't handle all of them. You might have to let one go. This is what this card represents. But guess what? Right next to it is the genie. So on approaching February 21st, when Mercury goes direct, the energy's fixing to switch. Okay, this is Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. I see the genie coming in, wanting to grant your every wish. This is what this card represents. So a lot of you are going to get a lucky break after Mercury goes direct on February 21st. The genie's coming in, especially Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio for you. All these cups here represent everything in your life, family, love, money, career, things like that. The genie's here to grant you all of those. Brand new day is coming. Yellow represents brand new day. And deep thought. I see you're on deep thought about it, and the genie is in deep thought about it too. The genie's coming in with passion. There's the red representing passion. He's got his feet firmly planted on the ground. If you see that, very, very intent on giving you what you want. So the universe is here to give you exactly what you want. So work on it, okay? Think about what it is that you want after February 21st and try to manifest it. Write it down on paper, light a candle, and start praying and start manifesting your wishes, because the genie is here to grant your wish. This is the card of wish fulfillment. Okay. So I'm seeing a lot of that coming in after February 21st. Okay. So now we have this card. Sorry, all my cards are so dirty. I ordered another deck and that's coming in just like this one. If you didn't watch my other video before on why I don't use other tarot cards, I showed y'all the witches. It's called a witch's modern deck or something like that. And I compared it to this one. And that's why I don't use any other tarot cards. So go watch that video. But these are extremely dirty. I've had these more for 20 years. And I keep trying to clean them off. But they just don't stay clean anymore. I did order another deck. This is the Rider Wyatt deck. The original deck that was first created for tarot reading. And that's the only deck, only cards that I use. This card is representing marriage. This is the American dream. You see the couple holding their hands up. They're looking at their home. Their children are happy playing. And they're in very, very deep thought about everything that they have achieved. This rainbow, again, just like the genie, represents everything in their life that's good. The home, the food, the money, the car, the career, friendship, and everything. And it's inside of a rainbow representing your wishes coming true. Heaven is about to deliver all this to you. This is also a baby card. So if you are a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, you might be announcing that you're going to have a baby in the end of February or are pregnant at the end of February or the beginning of March. Okay, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, you might be announcing that you are pregnant in March or at the end of February, want to have a baby or going to have a baby or already have had one. This is the American dream. So keep working on those dreams, manifest them. Okay. So last but not least, we have the judgment. This is the great aha card. I call it the great aha card. It's the awakening card. The angel is here to blast his horn. He's bringing in help. The Red Cross represents help for all of you that need help. The angel is coming, blasting his horn. He's waking up the people that are asleep. Are they dead? No, they're not dead, but they're not aware of anything. They're asleep in their thoughts. See the blue in their thoughts about their turbulent times. The water in the background is not smooth. That represents turbulent times. So a lot of you are in your mind. You're asleep in your mind, only thinking about these turbulent times. The angel is blasting his horn here to awaken you, to bring awareness to a new day is coming. This fell right underneath the wish card. Okay, so after February 21st, a new opportunity, the energy shift, a new day is coming, and you're going to be realizing things that you didn't realize before. That's why they call it the great aha card. You're going to be like, oh, aha, I didn't realize that before. So you'll be awakening to new ideas, new situations, new love relationships, new money opportunities, things like that. So stay aware. Stay aware after February 21st of what the universe is bringing in, because there's going to be a lot of opportunities coming in. Check them out, okay? Check them out first before you accept anything. Be aware of what's coming in. This is what I'm telling you. The universe wants you to know that they're coming in with lots of opportunities for all signs. Be aware of your surrounding events of what's coming in, all right? This is your weekend. I mean, this is your weekly energy for all signs, February 15th through the 21st. Mercury goes direct to February 21st, all right? Be aware of everything that's around you. Y'all, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Give me a big thumbs up. I'll see you next time, okay? Hit that notification bell so you'll be reminded when I upload another video. See you next time. Bye.